Okay, good morning again, everybody. Today, at first, I'm going to maybe share you with some slide, and maybe we have a little break, and we will come back to the some of the video. Let me show you the few situation on the project that we're going to talk about the water use group, and also the participatory process. Okay, okay, you can see my slide. Okay. And so today we will have a public quick discussion, you know, then we will have video, and then we come back with the final discussion about you know, the water user group and the importance of the participatory irrigation management together with the water user group. Okay. Yep. Okay, there are actually, officially, you know, about two water user group in irrigation project in Thailand. You know, first we have something called water user group. You know, this is mostly for the dish level. You know, or maybe we can combine more than one dish together. You know, to be one of the water user group. You know. And normally this will cover about 50 hectares, or sometimes it can be more or less, you know. That is very basic group of water user group, you know, that mostly we will be responsible for the operation, you know, for the kind of water scheduling, and responsibility for most of the maintenance and everything and their own dishes. And generally, in each water group, you know, they can have their own rule, their own regulation, and those kind of things. But they have some certain water allocation program that will be set up to them by the irrigation project. Or sometimes it can be set up by the next level of water user group. You know, that is an integrated water user group. Integrated water user is a big group, mostly it's on the lateral, you know, or even in sub-main of the system. You know, it means many water user group combined together to, into a big area, you know. You know, for the irrigation project, like a well, big one, something like if we have, let's say 50,000 hectare, you know, maybe it could be something like 10 water user group inside, you know, and each water user group probably could have something like 50 or number of water use group. So integrated water use group is kind of big one, and be responsible for allocate water to each subunit that is water use group. You know, that is very most common. Like I discussed yesterday, in the past, we start to use the water user group, and then we upgrade or combine them together to become integrated water user group. But like I recommend, and many other irrigation projects right now, it change. Okay, they will initiate the water user group, and then followed by the integrated water user group, you know. And the third kind of water use is a water user association. It is more or less similar to, let's say, integrated water user group, you know, but is actually registered not to the RID, you know, or your irrigation department. It registered to the Ministry of Interior, you know, like another association that we have seen, same regulation, you know. So it's more of a kind of legal status that can do, you know, like you can borrow money, you can do some other thing like as an association. Okay, that is another way, but not so many water user group or integrated water user group inside the irrigation project have used this direction. And the next one is water user corporation. This corporation, this cooperative, is registered to Ministry of Agriculture and Extension. The difference is if you register to the Ministry of Agriculture and Extension, mostly you relate to the Department of Cooperative Promotion. This department will have some kind of funding to support the cooperative. This means that you can borrow the money from the bank that is belong to the government, you know, it's called Bank of Agriculture and Cooperative, you know, so you can borrow money with a kind of rate interest less than when you borrow from the other source. And the last one here, we call the Joint Member Committee. It is actually the kind of, you know, very much unofficial. And it only happened, like I discussed yesterday, that it's a combined, you know, many group of, it's a activities of people for the whole river together, you know, to become a total organization. You know, you mean we have people from the upstream before irrigation project who have water use for maybe many purposes, like it can be for agriculture, it can be for, you know, like recreation, tourism, the kind of thing. And you can have the people from the irrigation project, you know, that have the water in many indicate water user group together, you know, and up at the downstream of the irrigation, you can have kind of, let's say, environmental control, you can have the city water use, fishery, you know, many other, okay? That is mostly covered everything that for the water user group in Thailand. But in general, you know, we will have basic as a water user group. And coming up, you know, we will have the so-called integrated water user group. And if it's so successful and the environment for working together, you know, between the people in the basin, you know, is so good, and the officer and the people have reached some agreement, you know, they can live or upgrade to joint member committee. That is mean the whole basin or the whole river have one joint committee, you know, to operate or to decide on water allocation, water sharing, or some other issue related to, you know, how we go to distribute the water to each sector or to each group of people, and when they're going to be closed or open, those kind of things. Okay. And this is just a summary, you know, the water use group, you know, characterized by the irrigation project size. We can have a small, large, and medium, you know, we can see that. If, you know, we are going to have an integrated water user group, you know, that is different than the other group. Because that integrated water user group, if it's on the, let's say, large scale or medium scale irrigation, it has to be registered nationally to the ID head office. You know, but the other water user group is mostly registered to ID, or the other one that the association registered to Ministry of Interior, that they will have a representative on the provincial area. And the other one is Water Use Cooperative that also registered to Ministry of Agriculture. They will also have some kind of representative in the province level too. Okay, is it? So this, I will give you today some example of the project. You know, we some maybe two small irrigation project, and maybe very large scale irrigation project. Okay, and the. This is the first one. It's called Huay Phai Irrigation Project. It's in north of Thailand. You see, you can see that the blue color is the river, you know, and the white, the yellow on the top, that is the reservoir. And you can have that, you see the river flow through the area and go to the big river underneath on the bottom of the slide. And the red one, that is a weir. You can see the red one is a weir on the river. You can see they have more than 10 weirs along the river. And the branch, the blue color, you know, that separate from the main stream, that is the canal that have been constructed by the farmer, you know. So actually, this project for the whole thing, only the reservoir construct by the Royal Irrigation Department, you know. The weir, the weir downstream is called is a farmer weir, you know, construct by the farmer, you know, using maybe less permanent material, you know, not really concrete, you know. Sometimes they can use wood or some kind of other material, you know, in order to uplift the water. And the canal itself is mostly been done by hand, you know, made a long times ago by the farmer. Actually, it has been, this project, it has been here before the construction of the reservoir. But since they have water shortage, they have request for the, you know, construction reservoir, so we can have you know, more water in the dry season. So you can see that it's actually cover the whole sub district, you know, of one area. You know, you can see that, you know, the pink of Upper Rai, that is a kind of invade village area, you know. Okay, so here they have 21 weirs, you know, a downstream of the reservoir with the capacity of 825,000 MCM. Cubic meter, you know. And the annual flow for this stream is about 6 million, you know. So the irrigation area is around 480 hectare. That is quite big, you know, cover the whole village, and I think it's more than one village, you know, covered by this stream or this project that actually run totally by the farmer, you know. Why this happened? You know, we can have the weir construct totally by the farmer, the canal construct totally by the farmer, because in northern, people have a really some kind of a strong irrigation background, you know, and they have kind of good cooperation between each other. That's why they can form this group, you know. They also have water fee charging, you know, for the member since 1989, you know. And the funding that we collect as a water fee will be the kind of, you know, set up fund, you know, for the group. So when the funding is bigger and bigger, they allow people to borrow with the 20% of interest rate, you know. So it's kind of people borrow money from their own group, you know. Yeah. Okay, this one is quite extensive, you know, when they go to water money collecting among their own group and set up the borrow scheme inside their own group. Okay. This is some kind of regulation that have been written down, you know, by themselves. Okay, about the funding, you know, the profit, like I said, that is 20% annual interest, 30% will go to the member, everybody in the group. 20% will go to bonus to the committee. Actually, committee not only look after the funding, they also look after the weir, you know, and the canals. But of course, on the maintenance, there will be kind of everybody had to be involved, you know. And they have reserved 30%, you know, to be a kind of long-term funding or long-term reserve. And there we have some 10% as a benefit for the total village, you know, like somebody have a, somebody die, something that, you know, some disaster that they should help the other, the capsing. And they also have money for ceremony, like they have Songkran or some kind of Songkran festival, you know, so or some other thing that is the, let's say, festival or ceremony of the village, okay? So in this project, they have a kind of three steps of development. You know, at first, you know, they don't have the reservoir at all, but they consult with the ID provincial office that, okay, we have water shortage. How can we secure water for the dry season? So they talk with the ID officer and come out with, okay, we are short of water and maybe the solution. We got to help by construct the reservoir because they already have the weir in place. They already construct the canal by themselves. So all member, BC irrigation officer agree that, okay, the solution probably going to be the reservoir and the ID will help them, okay? So at first they have a look at the possibility in engineering. Okay, if they're going to construct reservoir, is it going to be okay? You know, and ID have enough funding, you know, they have to file the proposal to the head office, you know, by, okay, the grouping of problems, you know, and they rank, okay, apart from the resource, what is the other alternative, what is the follow-up, they're going to work among them in the group, okay, and the finding, they say, okay, we could have reservoir, and this reservoir, we have solid water for domestic and some for agriculture, you know, and also they could have some kind of other activity with the reservoir, and also they got some have discussion earlier that if they have reservoir, what should be done, not only reservoir alone, okay? That we will call here it process of thinking together. Mm-hmm. This is the kind of development process for this. It will be a common for many other irrigation small-scale project in Thailand, you know? And second process being called is a process of doing together, okay? So the irrigation officer have a project plan and then find that the two regional office, you know, and have they have cost estimation, they do the budgeting and the work plan and implementation plan. But actually for the whole process, since the plan, the estimation, budgeting, work plan, up to the construction, they work along with the water user group, you know, all of them. You know, but actually this is, we can talk about 21 years. I think they have some kind of maybe 15 or so small water user group inside, you know, combined together. Okay, so this is process of doing together. And so finally, we come to the process of benefit together. You know, we've got the mutual benefit among the water user that first of all, farmer have more income, you know, from the water that they can grow crops with the supplementary in the wet season, you know. But actually in this area, wet season is not so much problem, just only once sometime. But of course, the dry season, they can have another crops, you know, probably going to be a cash crop or maybe kind of vegetable. Or if the water is sufficient, they can grow kind of rice too. And mostly everything, then they grow vegetable, you know. Okay, they can learn about correct maintenance. So it means that the maintenance we do by themselves, you know, if it's not big, you know, for the new construction, but of course the weir and the canal will be maintained by themselves, you know, and they can have kind of feeling of ownership. Because this original project, the weir and the canal is belong to them, and then they have addition of a reservoir that they operate by themselves, you know, and it has been transferred to the, I think, water user group along with the local administration, see that so that the maintenance is transferred to Wajasu Group, and then it can save the money by the government. So after completion, we'll be only handing over totally to the Wajasu Group. But of course, they still have some kind of technical assistance from the officer, you know, and they have the cooperation, you know. And importantly, finally, there is satisfaction by the farmer because they do everything by themselves. Okay. So this is some regulation regarding water management of the globe. First of all, they have water allocation according to water supply in the reservoir. So I mean, they see that. We have a look how much water they have in their system, and then they decide, okay, how much will be allocated, you know, for each activity. And then they have decide their delivery stream from upstream to downstream by group. So even we are, you know, from first to the last we are, you know, but because this is set up it different, you know, from one place to the other place. Like maybe the other project that we talk to you, maybe a big irrigation project, you know, after we complete the video, they will be kind of downstream first and then upstream. But the project, they go upstream first and then downstream, but somehow they can have a kind of sharing water that they can work together. Because they have a penalty on water stealing, so they have the quota, how much water each people, each party can take, you know. And also the other thing is they have kind of fine, you know, for the payment of absent in terms of maintenance of the canal and the ditch, you know, because they also have canal, you know, and they have another ditch that is a branch of the canal that they have to maintain together. Okay. So this is just kind of conservation, you know. So in the wet season, they go right mostly because this is the kind of lowland area. But in the dry season, they don't grow rice. Mostly they grow vegetable. I think it is maybe probably chili, you know. Is it onion, you know, okay. And yeah, see the case is onion. And they also going forward. Also in 2006, come a kind of organic farm. You can see here that they don't use the pesticide, you know. Maybe they can use some fertilizer or maybe not, but they don't use pesticide. You know, they have been talking with the department and get some expert to recommend them, you know, to do organic farm. What should they do? You know, okay. They decide, they discard, and they get along, you know, with the, okay. Actually, the guy on the left-hand side of the last picture, he's the leader of the whole water user group. You know, sorry that I can't remember his name now, but he's the, and the guy on the right-hand side on the bottom, that I think is the officer on irrigation. And the guy in the middle, I think it's the officer from the maybe Department of DOE, agricultural extension, I think. Yeah, I have seen that. Okay, this is just the training program on organic farm. You know, yeah, that, you know, after they agree that we go organic, they have the training, working together. By the way, this project in Payao province, you know, in the north of Thailand. Okay, and I think it have been mentioned about Wi-Fi. I'm not sure about talking about Payao. You know, so they also have some supporting advice from many agencies. Like they have local irrigation on the provincial office to assist them in irrigation, water allocation, those type of thing, and Ministry of Agriculture cooperative help them, you know, on some other issue like you know, organic farm, those kind of processing, and Department of Agriculture Extension here, you know, and Land Development Department help them on soil improvement, use, you know, kind of compost, you know, rather than fertilizer. And of course, they have fishing, you know, in the reservoir, also inside the project themselves, you know, by the assistant of Department of Fishery here. Okay, so we have a lot of line agency, you know, showing them. Is it just kind of fishery? I think it's inside the reservoir, and they have kind of system of sharing of profit. I think they allow somebody to have the quota to fish inside the reservoir with limited number to be sure that the water quality will not be affected, and some profit will be sharing back to the group. Of course, the one who fish here get the benefit, but it's kind of agreement between people. But who will be the one who allow to have fish farm inside the reservoir? You know, because it got to be fixed number. You know, if too many water quality will be deteriorated. That will be not so good. Okay, is it kind of fit from there? And this is domestic water supply. Oh, I forgot to tell you that. Okay, they have a priority of water, domestic water supply. So they have one of the small canal, you know, that actually divert the water to the very big pond inside the village to store the water. That so be sure that, okay, they could have water for the whole dry season, you know, in this big pond, you know. So this is pond is actually separate from the reservoir, you know, to be installed for domestic only, you know, because they think that, okay, they have the farming of fish farm inside reservoir. So maybe dry season water, they're not so sure about water quality, so they have their, you know, the pond here to store the water for domestic. But of course, if the water insufficient in the dry season, they can divert more water from the reservoir to this farm pond that will be big only for, you know, water supply, domestic water supply. You can see here. Really big one. Mm-hmm. I think I'm sure. I think it's more than a hectare or a hectare, something like that. Okay. Is it just a canal that have been constructed, you know, by the officer to help them divert the water to the farm pond? That is, you know, for and the public ponds. So in case of somebody want to store the water. You know, not using directly the water from the reservoir or from the weir. They can have a farm pond to store water in the wet season. So this is some kind of additional. So apart from the reservoir, weir, they have farm pond, you know, to be extra water storage for the public and for people, okay? So this is the whole, actually this is the water user group, you know? The guy on the right hand side who are sitting is the leader of this group, and also the leader of the whole group. It is the separate group. This is another smaller group. Another one here. Yeah. Okay, that it just show you. This is kind of participatory. So before the start of the season, everybody will come up together to remove the weed. You know, here they try to remove the weed. Okay, you see it? Remove the weed, taking out the sediment. Okay, and then have some kind of discussion together on the, you know, situation of water, water allocation, solving of problem together. This is the leader of the group coming together to discuss. Okay, this is the kind of, you know, so everybody who have used the water have to participate in this maintenance. If not, you get to pay the money to as a absent fee, you know, instead. Okay, this is kind of ceremony of the village. Okay, it's just a kind of meal after the let's say the maintenance or some other ceremony. Okay. They have award, you know, good project, you know, national project for good irrigation. That, I mean, good example for some other in 1991. Okay, this is, and they also had the Rio Project Award. And the project had been taken to the Rio Project Award because of the, initially when they request the Rio Award, they request directly to the office in Rio office in Bangkok initially, you know, for before the second Rio Award. That's why they are also under the Rio scheme too, okay? So this is award, okay? So what is the key success of these farmers working together as a group? You can see that they have the meeting together, discussion, solving problem, planning, and they have been on the maintenance together. Of course, they have been on the water allocation by themselves, planning, you know, like I have show you the setup on the water allocation among themselves. So this is the, actually the guy in the mid here on the blue shirt, this is the officer who initiated the whole thing from the start of the construction of reservoir, bringing together and some other relay, you know, he's the ID officer, you know. Okay, that is the first one in the north of Thailand. Maybe I can show you another one. We call it Good Ling Ngor Irrigation Project in Udon Thani. I'm so also working on this project, you know. This is dam itself, you know, it have the capacity of 16 million, quite big. It's about 16 million. Oh, sorry, the reservoir itself is, I think it's 3 million, something like that. Or 6 million, sorry, 6.4 million. And on the top, that is data of the rainfall, annual flow, those kind of things. You know, and the reservoir capacity is 6 million. You know, that quite, we can call a medium scale irrigation reservoir, you know, medium scale reservoir. Okay, this is just the kind of water distribution system, you know. So this kind of medium scale project, we will not be handing over to the farmer totally. It will be kind of Rural Irrigation Department still taking control of the reservoir, but the canal, the distribution, and the other, it will be operated totally by the farmer. ID only look after in terms of maintenance of the reservoir, but the operation mostly handing over to the farmer. I think that we have some kind, maybe one officer be at the reservoir to be sure that the operation it have been done correctly. Apart from that, the whole system operate by the farmer. You know, it have only one officer to help them to look after the reservoir. See, it's big, you know, it's about 6 million, you know, and annual info is a lot. So the proper operation is quite important, you know, that's why it have a big risk of, you know, failure or bit of wrong operation, those type of thing. Okay, and this is irrigation area. You can see the dam is here, the reservoir is here, and the irrigation area is here, you know. It's in Udon Thani, you know, in the northeast of Thailand. Total area 1,400 hectare, you know, and in this 1,400 irrigation area, 995 hectare, you know, and like I showed you earlier from the early picture, they have constructed this here, you know, and this is land use, you know, they have been separate the water use into three groups, you know. So the first one is for cultivation. They have rice, they have orchard, they have vegetable, they have many other activity, you know, very, very diverse in terms of, you know, land use. Of course, they have also livestock here, you know, for cow, pig, chicken, many others, you know. And they have fishery, you know, they have aqua farm pond in each farm. You see, they also have some problem that raised up by people here. They say they have excessive use of the chemical, or they think it, they saw it degrade, you know, by using too much fertilizer, and also the yield is reduced. So they have the policy. You know, sorry. They they have policy to reduce the chemical, you know, and maybe transform themselves to organic, you know. Sorry. Okay, and is it just the water allocation inside is Kulingo, you know, they have domestic supply. Sorry, that is not million, you know, it's cubic meter per year. Sorry, you know. The domestic supply is 27,000 cubic meter per year, you know. And the wet season cultivation, that is about 4.5 million cubic meter, and dry season is 1.7, you know. And this is the water use, you know, each year, you know, and irrigation area for the wet and the dry season here, okay. So here. Okay. Okay. This is just a concept of water management of this Kulingo, you know, because they are a medium scale project, you know. As per they have analysis of water balance, they define the rule for the reservoir operation, you know, they define the target area for the wet and dry season by themselves, you know, so the analysis of water balance, it obviously helps them. The rule of reservoir operation is mostly agreement between officer and the water user group. Of course, the irrigation area is designed by water user group for the dry season, for the wet season, and then the officer helps them to calculate the crop water requirement, to check, you know, of the water requirement, you know, okay. Water resources, that is crop water requirement and water resources, and then come out with delivery plan, you know, and inform the farmer and have the agreement with the farmer, okay. And then we can have a weekly monitoring and adjustment. So it means that after the plan has been placed, it can be adjusted according to the farmer, you know, on weekly basis, you know, and they can have a report on the water delivery and cultivation system. Okay, here. This is just the activity, you know, on the water use association here. You can see that they have dividing of this and water user group. You know, so they have, you know, like making all together, you know, as a water user group, you know, how many dish, you know, they have canal and then dish, how many dish combined together to be one water user group, you know, so they have construct a few dish, some by themselves, some by the officer, you know, of course, they have to be participate in the weed removal of seal from the dish, and canals, because actually the dish belong to them, the canal still belong to the project. Okay. But they're handing over the maintenance operation to the farmer. Okay. The planning of the cropping pattern with the RID assistant, you know, and they have the development of the recreation area. You see that because this wood, it lasts a bit, you know. So they have some kind of set up location area nearby the reservoir for the people, you know, in the sub-district here in this area, you know, and they've been trained on irrigation, on cultivation, giving some knowledge on marketing, you know, and those kind of other things like organic farm, those kind of things, you know. And they have put the conflict resolution or the, let's say the regulation themselves, you know, among the member, you know, they were okay, but what can be the regulation for their own group? And of course, they use the reservoir at the aquaculture sources. And I think they have kind of a harvesting time that people could catch a fish, you know, together, you know, because this aquaculture in Irrawaddy belong to the village, you know, that they can benefit together. The group also have very good tie together, you know, between people, and they also have award a good water use group in 1989, you know, the international one. The last one that I will talk before the break and we come out to the video, this is called the Integrated Water Use Group. It's in Hue Samyon. This is Phetchaburi. Actually, it's the main area that I'm working with in the last maybe 10 years because it's close to my campus. My campus in the central of Thailand, you know, north of Bangkok, you know. So this Hue Samyon in Phetchaburi, you know, in west of Bangkok, western region. You know, this is reservoir. This is show you the reservoir. Actually, it's on the foot of the mountain. You know, okay. And it's on the Kangkachan district. Actually, Kangkachan is kind of mountainous area. You know, they have small reservoir with the pipe distribution system. You know, for domestic water supply and for agriculture. So it can be used. You know, this pipe. So you can see that this is the first project. But the solution is, I think mostly it's PVC pipe, you know. And of course, the water is insufficient, you know, because of the wet season, people can grow maybe up to 80 or 90 hectare, but in the dry season, it can be reduced to something like 43 hectare because the amount of water in the reservoir itself. Apart from the cultivation, they have something like animal farm and maybe, you know, some labor work. Okay. This is just to show you some pictures, you know, of Hue Samyon on the activity of their water use group. They have a coordination with the government agency, you know, on the agricultural development, you know, monitoring of the irrigation sector, and, you know, maintain it to be on the condition of ready to use. They have the monitoring on the, you know, water use of each member or the group according to the plan, you know, to be sure that water have not been used too much, because you see this is a pipe system. It means the water can deliver to the farmer, you know, offer to people, you know, first for domestic use, secondly for agriculture, very easily. That's why they have monitored it. Have to be monitored it closely to be sure that nobody use too much water, you know. And of course, they have to be participate in operation, you know, maintenance, and also distribution by the people, because the whole project is totally operated by the farmer or water user group. They have some problem. I tell you that their reservoir, I didn't tell you the, I think capacity, the reservoir is less than 1 million. Actually, I'm not sure how much, but it's less than 1 million. You know, since the reservoir is small, you know, and it's close to national park, so you cannot enlarge the reservoir. And the upstream of the reservoir, they cannot use the land for any other thing, you know, except conservation, you know. And okay, they have some kind of hydration after having used for some time, and the maintenance it. Need replacement is need, so it come out with okay. They have to collect the money from the user group to maintain that. You know, this is just amount of money they collect, about not so much, you know, about 1,000 or above $1,000 for the maintenance of the pipe system. You know, for the whole, they just, you know, use the money to buy the material, and the maintenance is done by themselves. Okay, everything. So this is the duty of the member, you know, of the group, they have to participate in water supply management to match with the water requirement. They have to have they have meeting on the monthly basis, you know, for discussion, for hearing, for exchange, you know, and they're gonna have to kind of solution together, you know, regarding water use, you know, okay, how much water and how, what is the situation, those kind of things. And the members of the water use group have been given their responsibility. Okay, this guy responsible for, you know, open the tap, and other things, you know, and look after the somebody look after the, you know, water allocation had to be monitoring the water in the reservoir, be sure that, you know, it's no excessive use, and do somebody steal the water or not, or the type of thing, you know, everybody have some kind of duty, you know, to do the job inside the reservoir or inside their own water use group, you know. And they have been set up clear date of meeting. They had the 5th of the month. You know, they don't use say okay Monday or Tuesday. Okay, so monthly on the 5th. You know, so they all member have to follow the regulation of their own group. Okay, this is water chart. It's $1, I think, per season. Right now, it's increased. Not $1. I think it's not. $5 or something like that, you know. You know, for domestic each household for the season. I think maybe wet season, dry season, it's not so much. You know, it only for the maintenance of the system. Agriculture have been paid on lump sum, you know, then so for domestic, you know, it's $1 or $1.5 lump sum. And for agriculture, it have been also some other a kind of estimate amount of youth, and they will charge the money, you know, to be the funding for the group for the maintenance. This kind of sorry. Next is the water management. So the water use is based on the amount of water in the reservoir. The water can be used for the household. You know, at that time. Being no loud, my system is monitored. But they have monitored the quality and the cleaning of water, you know, and of course they have been all the time to be sure there's no damage or no leakage, you know, because this is the major source of water for both household and earlier, household is the main priority. You know, after that, okay, then we can calculate how much we use for our paper. This is a system to be sure that it's good collection, no leakage. Water for agriculture normally is in a much bigger amount compared to water for domestic. If they have water shortage, you know, then we have the assistance from the local administration, you know, or maybe. This is just some kind of activity of what they use, you know, they have farm, they have chicken, they have cow, they have vegetable, you know, so it's very diverse, you know, the diversify is really also good for this project that they have many activities, you know, and this is the participation. It's not only, you know, the training of the, you know, the recent panel. I think the picture on the bottom, that is actually creating the watershed of the reservoir. That too, because of there's so many weed coming in, you know, so to participate in also weed cleaning inside the watershed too. Initiation, you know, we have water conservation, every detail, protection too, you know, not only about and lastly, so I mean, development and conservation. People are encouraged to drip and sprinkle. Use too much water, lost too much water, so they encourage to use drip or mini sprinkler, you know, and they have water user group working closely with the local administration, you know, and they also have the people participate in forest protection, you know, like be sure that nobody cutting down the tree, you know. That's why important for them to work together. Also, for the awareness of conservation of the forest, you know. So we, this actually the bottom picture is the that military, that is the forest officer working around people on the conservation of, because of the, like I tell you earlier, this is the area next to the nation, just close to the border. Of that, so they need to labor together with the park, which is a forest, to preserve the forest. So this is the key factor for this project. First, they have initiative of farmer and officer. We can call it the most of trust with the farmer. And the officer to start of the project go together as ID is working together, and the first thing is opposite. They are think they're similar to the first project that I'm talking about, Wi-Fi in Payao. This is they are thinking together, they are implementing it together and benefit together. They have water use, you know, at board level one. So they have, I think, I'm not sure how many small group, 4 or 5 group, you know, something like that. And that's combined to be a big water user group or integrated water user group, you know, and they're listening once everything in place. Small group and then combined together to be a big group. You know, actually this water user group is not registered to ID, you see, because it's small scale and it's bring it operate. So small water user group and big budget scope, it all is totally operated by the farmer themselves. Okay. Of course, they have water fee collect for the operation, but mostly for the maintenance. You know, there and they have the regulation set up by themselves, you know, on the penalty of, you know, use excessive water, stealing water, or traffic. You know, and ID is only advisor, you know, for some type of operation and maintenance. But of course, decision is making by water user group throughout the process, you know, and they have kind of saving also, you know, and they kind of get buying the input for the farm together, like buying chemist, you know, chemical or buying some other input like seed, if any, or some other thing together, so they get a better price and, you know, the bargaining price of the groups, and they have good leadership and tradition of working together, and they need to support themselves. Yeah. So to show you Is it just we are in Chiang Mai, that is close to Payao, then that is a tradition we are in Thailand, you know, that constructed by farmers. I think many of them still work in the northern part, but I don't mean that this one is in February, but it's a kids' temple that which we can be even constructed in the big stream. Okay, if it just some show you some kind of different type of beer that have been constructed in the steam, you know, in the area. It's not just in the project, you know. This picture is not in the project, okay? Just to show you general picture of the beer around this Chiang Mai. It's the beer in the central plain. Different, you know, in Chiang Mai, traditional, they do this beer. But when go to the central plain, mostly the way it's come to concrete more. Because in the north, they have a rock, they have a bamboo, but in central, maybe different. And so they may use more of the concrete and more of the permanent structure. Okay, we will have a break, maybe 10 minutes, and we'll come up to show you some video. You know, and maybe share with you the detail of irrigation project. One is a large scale, and this one is small scale in February, same area. You know, and how do they work together? And we have the opportunity to see them and interview them. Actually, have been with working with them for quite some time, but since the COVID or some other thing, we haven't been there for a long, long time. You know. Okay, we have a break, maybe 10 minutes, and we come back later to show you some video and then discuss about this project of petbury operation and maintenance, and then poison side that is small scale. Okay, go back now. We have a short break, and we'll come back to discuss together about, you know, this video that we have been setting up for you to see. You know, the project in February. Okay. Sorry that the sound will be in Thai, so I cut the sound. The one English is on the progress. If finished, I will be notify you and let you download it. Actually, will be within this week. But sorry that now we have only Thai, so I cut the sound. You know, maybe only my explanation. Okay, for this video.
จังหวัดเพชรบุรีมีพื้นที่ประมาณ 6,225 ตารางกิโลเมตรหรือ 3,897,711 ไร่ตั้งอยู่ทางภาคกลางตอนล่างของประเทศไทยสภาพภูมิประเทศเป็นภูเขาและที่ราบสูงแล้วค่อยๆลาดต่ำลงมาทางทิศตะวันออกจึงเกิดเป็นสันปันน้ำแบ่งน้ำเป็นต้นน้ำของแม่น้ำเพชรบุรีและแม่น้ำปราณบุรี
โอเค is it
ทำให้ทิศตะวันตกของจังหวัดเพชรบุรี
is it the Phetchaburi irrigation project you know it's on the western basin it have the Kangkachan at the storage dam and Pet at the dam is it you can see the windFrom the southwest and northeast that affect the area. Okay, this is the main reservoir at Storage Dam. That is the diversion dam, and this is just the day we take video, you know, to show you that is about last month. Okay, this is irrigation area. You know, they have the left and the right. This is the main canal. You know, on the right hand side.This is just some detail about this reservoir, you know. Of course, they have some kind of quite a lot of activity there. They have water user group. Let's install this. They have water group, but initially, this water group is initiated by IID without really some kind of activity together. You know, they have no consequence. They have no group activity.They have no meeting, they have no participation, it's kind of the group according to the laws, you know, that they have to have the group. Otherwise, they cannot receive the water. The mostly irrigation in Thailand is like this, you know. They have to form the water user group in order to get the water. But actually, it's no activity, you know, just the register system, you know, for everybody to have it, okay? So we have kind of installation of the new water user group. You know, this is the officer actually is my friend in the front. He talked with the farmer that they go to be, let's say, reconstruct the water user group to be more effective and working together. So they start with people with the whole big lateral system. I think the area here is a kind of more than 10,000 hectares, something like that, 10,000 hectares for this branch. You know, working together, have the agreement that we're going to be reinstalled. This is actually my group. This is the Dr. Baru, one of our faculty members, you know, working along. This is the leader of the farmer and the officer. The officer is on the right. The leader on the farmer is on the middle. You know, okay, together they're going to initiate. Also, some of my faculty is here. And they have, okay, agree to work together. You know, and this is, they call it Balam Patana Integrate Water User Group. You know, and this is just, they start with the water user group and then integrate water user group. But after this group have been working together for a long, long time, they have been upgraded, you know, to some kind. I mentioned earlier, it's all integrate, joint management committee that have been look after everything. This is just agreement between themselves. Okay, they're going to coming together, working together as a group for the water management of the particularly O&M. This is actually the service agreement at the final stage, you know, after some year working together, they come out to state of the service agreement with IB with this cut later. Okay. It's about the detail of the service agreement. This is actually the signing ceremony, you know, and this agreement will also be notified to the local administration, even to the district, to be sure that everybody know or understand what is the legislation of working together, you know, in this irrigation project. Okay. So it's just some kind of activity, you know, people working together, getting the order on hand, discussion about the regulation, this kind of agreement. You know, this is just a lot of discussion going on here, you know. So sorry that the sound mixing will be handing to you in the later version. You know, this is actually the sound all in Thai, you know, because of we haven't got enough time to write the script in English. Okay, they have the award winning, you know, for good water user group and get the first prize from RID office that is about 100,000 baht. Quite some money, you know, for the good water user group. Okay, on for the large scale irrigation project. This is just I am discussed with the the second generation of leader on the left here, and this guy on the right, he is a former RID officer who are now retired and still work with the farmer, you know, because he is also people here, and this is another guy, you know, he's a kind of irrigation volunteer to help on the monitoring of the water, you know, in this branch of the irrigation. You know, this is just a learning center for everything, for agriculture, for related IT tool like fertilizer, you know, or some other thing like they can solve new theory kind of It's just this is agriculture, you know, on the knowledge and technology, you know, and they go the rice and rice, you know, and they this is some detail, you know, that they are learning from the technology here. They reduce a lot of use of water, you know, and they use, I think, actually less the water than the ordinary dry season. Dry season rice mostly use more than 1,000 kilometers. But this project, they use only 800 or 900. Use some kind of wet and dry technique. You know, this here wet and dry technique. And it can reduce carbon emission, and no, sorry, methane emission. And they get even the carbon credit from the kind of organization for 300 parts per ride for the wet and dry technique. And this wet and dry technique is monitored by the satellite, by the organization that give them the funding. So they get the new the funding from the outside. The people around here also use their new theory. New theory is initiated by the former King Rama the IX, you know, about using the land, some part for the water, some part for vegetable, some part for tree, some part for cultivation rice, and those kind of things, you know. So they know how to separate the land. And this is just the extension of their knowledge. You know, this is the measurement instrument in the field for wet and dry. You know, so when the water, they're going to let the water going down a little bit before the next irrigation. And they have to do this at least twice a season of rice growing. And they will get 300 baht in return from the organization that support them on the reduction of the methane emission. And the whole thing is monitoring by satellite, you know, by the organization themselves. You know, this is quite another step forward, you know, by the farmer themselves to have a smart agriculture, you know, and let's say environmental friendly, you know, agriculture. And it's initiated by the farmer because this guy is a kind of participate a lot. You know, this is just about, you know, pounding on rice and water deduction, you know. This is we met together last month, you know, to discuss about detail, about their learning, about their progress in studying from their traditional rice field to be more of environmental friendly, of wet and dry, you know, irrigation technique, you know, that can have use less water, 20% or 30% less, and more than 50% less methane emission into the field. You know, that is quite good, you know, for the environment and even for the carbon credit of the country. Okay. And IID now is try to promote this for the whole country or for the irrigation project all around the country. Okay. Yeah, this is just kind of the new theory farm, you know, that have been practiced by the farmer, but it's kind of adapt, you know, a new theory that maybe they have farm pond that you also use for fish and they can have the land for summer, you know. And, you know, so it's kind of good because this thing is mean that they have been distribute the farm or the land to many other activity. So the risk is reduced. You know, it means good for economics of people in the farm, you know, because they have been able to have some fish, you know, some vegetable, and also sometimes this area is also they have the cattle raising, you know, for, you know, they buy sometimes some of them maybe buy the mature one and raise them to be a bit more and sell as cattle, and some of them just raise the cattle to get the young one, you know, to for the market. You know, this is kind of many activity, you know, both livestock, agriculture, fishery, and diversified crops by the farmer themselves. This is just show you the general picture of the what is the new theory talking about farm pond there, talking about rice field, talking about household, talking about you know, tree, vegetables. So it's a kind of adapt new theory, you know, from the former King Ramadanai to be adaptable to themselves, you know. Okay, yeah. This is the, okay, the you know, like, okay, they also have the rice meal, you know, invest by themselves, you know, by some money from the Bank of Agriculture and Cooperative. You know, they, many of them have organic farm, you know, so this rice meal is for organic rice, you know, by themselves. Okay, they can go along, you know, they say it's, the rice meal for the happiness. This is the product of their rice meal, you know, that is mostly organic rice. And they sell this like this product directly to the consumer. You know, you can see many package. Actually, it's depending on the rice variety on this area. And they cooperate with the people in the south of Thailand, in the other part of Thailand, in order to deliver. And this is just about the market, you know. In this area, we have the central market for the fruit, you know, actually it's the biggest, that it belong to the cooperative, you know, not this group, but the big group of the whole district become agricultural cooperative, you know, we call Thayang Agricultural Cooperative, that have been maybe the biggest in the country, you know, because it really bought the whole product of vegetable of fruit in the area, you know. That's why the farmer have bargaining, you know, all the market by themselves, because this market is by the cooperative, not by the private. And on regarding the climate change and climate ability, you know, people realize that, you know, and that why they have the security of themselves by having the water storage, you know, by adapting the new theory that we have the farm pond that it can be used for, you know, irrigation too. They can use for fishing, many other things, okay, by themselves. Yeah, this is just the new generation that are coming along to learn about, you know, farming and sustainable agriculture, you know, in the area. Let's say that. Okay, go ahead. Don't stop. Just let it flow. Okay, this is just the another finish of the one. Okay, we go to the another project called Hue Sam Yot. This is No, sorry, Hue Song Sai Reservoir in the same area as the Petbury. Okay. Is it just a reservoir that we have visit and talk to the farmer here? Farmer here grow many things, like some of them grow cassava, some of them grow sugarcane, some of them grow rice, some of them have vegetable like pomelo, some of them have like lemons. Something, so it's quite diverse, you know. This is the construction is about 30 years ago, you know. This is just on the by the side of the reservoir, you know. This is also kind of a recreation area for people in the village too, you know. This is just the them side. This is just a reservoir and the agriculture area. Go along, don't stop. Don't let it flow. Don't stop at all. Okay. So I'm sorry to communicate with my support. This is agriculture, and we have installation of the World Teachers Group. You know, in this reservoir, this is just organization chart. You know, of the small group together, four group to become the integrated water user group, working together. You know, with the assistance of the RID. You know, actually they have some problem. You know, on actually this is not the first one they are working on, you know. This one is just the one after we call it reinstallation of the group, you know, after they have the problem. Okay. Yep. It's just after the process, you know, because before that they just do using water, have the globe, but they have water shortage, you know, because too much water have been used, you know, this kind of thing. And of course, this project also use the pipe system, you know, to in order to reduce the water loss, you know. Okay. So once, you know, they have water shortage problem, you know, they come out with, you know, some kind of research. We call it social research, you know. You know, this is the social research that coming to the area to let people understand among themselves how much water do they have, what is activity. This guy is actually the one who was leader of the social research or village research that coming. This is the officer, irrigation officer that working on the start, okay. Understand about the water, understand about cropping, understand about availability, understand about the failure, about water shortage, because everybody compete to have the water and water is not enough. So they, when once they study themselves, learn about themselves, you know, about the problem, they start to have the regulation, you know, and then this is just crop and activity. It's going to be a lot of diversion, you know, many crops. And this is just schematic that coming out from that social research by themselves, understand what is the route of the canal and what is the water user and how can it be regulated, you know, on this one. We see that this is just the calendar of after that meet learning. Okay, what dry season calendar, wet season calendar, they come out together to set up this. Okay, this is just the JMC that they're setting up after that social research, you know, or domestic research about themselves. They have the method of the delivery of water setting up for themselves, like they have flow group, you know, they have talking about how much water and how water will be allocated, you know, okay, when the water is lower to some level, it will be only used for, you know, domestic, no more agriculture, you know, and the operation of system, like how many day open, how many day off, you know, okay, that is 60% can use for agriculture, 50% that we saving scheme, 30% no more water for agriculture. This kind of general regulation by the JMC, the Joint Management Committee, they set up. And people have to pay something like 40 baht per ride per season for the maintenance fee for per year, what it costs. You know, and anyone who break the rule, they have to be imposed or sanctioned or penalty, whatever. Maybe you don't get the water for the next rotation, you know. And of course, when they have the conflict, they have the meeting, they have the resolution, they have the understanding and coming out with the solution among themselves. Okay, that will be a good example of learning by, you know, research that they have the bad experience of water shortage. And when they come up together, you know, learning about themselves and then set up the regulation and then operate as a group together, things will be much better improved. This is about the knowledge and things they learn together, you know, after they work together and have somebody assist them. I just discussed with them by the side of this wall. This is the officer that I tell you, and the other farmer, I think some of them grow rice, some of the guy in the blue here grow sugar cane, I think. This lady probably go food tree. There's a guy go like chili. This one is grow, I think, vegetable. Yep. So they're discussing that, you know, what is their learning from working together since the social research and what have been improved you know, in of themselves, at least they say sugarcane, after they have good irrigation, good water control, it can irrigate maybe a few times a year, and the yield, it can be something like at least 50% increase of sugarcane per ride. Let's say per hectare is about, let's say, how many hectare? Oh, I think it's close to 100 ton per hectare, you know, for sugarcane. After they set up a good irrigation, that some irrigation per year, you know, using pipe system, you know, the capsing, and drip or the capsing, you know. So that's good for them, you know. So they have many farmers can work together, some grow food, vegetables, some have few crop, you know, they have no problem of water sharing, you know, and they have set up the regulation. Okay, fruit can have the water year round, but it have to be water saving. It have to go by drip irrigation, you know, and vegetable can grow only, you know, how many season, number of time, you know. And quite interesting in this area, you know, nowadays they go into technology, you know, they have communicate to each other, you know, using some kind of Facebook and Line, you know, so they work together in a kind of media that is up to date, you know, they have a Facebook and Line to communicate among people for the whole reservoir. So to be notified, of course, they have good support from the central market nearby that setting up by the cooperative on the district level. Yeah, this is the climate change adaptation, you know, they have learned a lot that climate is the risk, you know, so that why they have implement water saving seriously, you know, and set up, okay, if 30% or less water available in the reservoir, it will strictly used for agriculture. If more than that, 40%, 50%, 60%, it will be a kind of saving instruction. But of course, if it's more than 60%, it will be more or less restriction. It can be used for agriculture a lot, you know. This is just okay. And lastly, you know, for the sustainability and the future of the project, they have a kind of continuing, like the next generation, you know, coming to work with them, and they have they sell the product together, you know, coming together as a group, you know, and sell, you know, sing together, and they have the saving. This is the new generation, you know, and they have kind of saving of the money saving. They have it by input together, and they have work together, like getting the water upstream, downstream, who go first, who go after. But this one is no problem, you know, because since they have the pipe system, you know, it can be sure that, okay, downstream first or upstream first, it's not a problem. It depends on the discussion. And of course, they have the guy on the middle that is the supervisor from IID. Initially, before the research, you know, he's just look after the reservoir only, not actually working with the farmer a lot. But after research, you know, he think that, okay, if I work with the farmer, transfer some knowledge to them, working on the to get the regulation, those kind of things, you know, got to be helped a lot, you know. Okay, so what do we learn from here, from this Hui Songsai? In summary, first of all, they have reduced the risk of themselves by distribute it, you know, for many crops, you know, they grow not only rice or few crop, they have vegetable, they have chili, they apply the to other activity like animals, you know, sometimes even have fishery, they adopt the new theory, you know, for security, and they have access to good market that will be fair for them, you know, and vegetable, you know, and fruit, you know. And they have the learning center for themselves. They have the rice mill, so they have the access to the market by themselves. You know, so they get a, you know, good price of their output. You know, not just only sell to the merchant, those kind of things. So that's a lot. You know, we can learn from this area because it's a let's say a farmer kind of, you know, ready to learn. Are ready to adapt themselves. Okay, that be end of the video. We maybe share you with this, with the presentation to wrap up for today for us. Okay, this is just give you more detail about the two projects, Petbury and Hoi Song Sai. This is Petbury. If it brief, we take you maybe 10 or 15 minutes to wrap up before we come to an end. Okay, this is just the Petbury project. You know, we have Kengkachan Dam there. That is about watershed, it's 2,200 square kilometer, and active solid is big, 700 million. You know, watershed area for irrigation here, and you can here see the diversion dam, downstream of the river there. You can see the project area, 85,000 irrigation area. No, sorry, maybe the number. Okay, maybe this is correct. Okay, and they have 75,000 hectare in terms of irrigation area, and they have. Okay, four main canal, 41 breakwater, and the total distribution system, the main distribution system is 431 kilometer. This is just activity. They have agriculture, you know, rice, vegetable, you know, and they have support the domestic water supply for the whole province. Actually, not for the district, for the whole province. And they have, this is the next to the seaside. And the reservoir itself is used for recreation, you know. And this also, this reservoir, Kengkachan, is also important for flood protection in the area. They also have the water downstream of the pit dam for salinity control and ecology and fishery. And they also installed the hydropower plant after the completion some year because they see that it have the possibility. Is it just kind of meeting of water users together regularly every year, every season? They have a meeting. They have the training of the young or new generation. You see, they are playing together. This is just the, I talked earlier, that reinstallation or the water user group and integrate water user group. You see, and they have a meeting to discuss and solve the problem together. You know, and they have been going along with some of the organic farm and land improvement by compost rather than chemical fertilizer. You know, they have been participate in the maintenance, okay, on the of the dish and on the lateral. This is just show you the whole project, you know, that is Kengkachan Dam, and you know, the this is just the original water user group here in 1987. They have 640 water user group, 6 integrated water user group, you know. But after this reform, that take about 4 years for the group to become strong. After the reform, they have water user group, they are targeted 800, but I think up to that 2009, they have 616. I think right now they already meet the target. And at that time, they have 12 integrated water user group. Complete, it means it working group, you know, not just the group in the paper. No, what you mean? I know, you know what I mean? It's a working group, you know, that is already in place and people know, you know, and have participated in all the activity which we discussed earlier. Meeting on the reform, you know, quite a number of years, you know, we could come out to success. you know, this is just inform local administration, everybody involved, in terms of, and of course, they have the thinking together, and responsible together, so everybody have their own, role, water use group have the local administration, and also we have training, we have management, water meeting, the type thing. This is actually, this picture show you the Gangajan and Paint Dam, and like here is the Hui Song Sai, on the down, on the bottom, that the Hui Song Sai is in the southern area. Actually, it's another sub basin of this river. And actually, Hui Sam Pha or Hui Sam Yod, in the other area that I discussed earlier, is on the Hui Pha on the bottom left, yellow here, and Hui Song Sai on the pink there. It's in the same basin. That's why I give you example of this river basin or this province, because it have good kind of cooperation and group working together. Okay, this is to show you where it's peppery in Thailand. You see, this Thailand is on the western, next is on the west is Myanmar, on the right is the Gulf of Thailand. Okay, this is a project. This is just the Hui Song Sai. Hui Song Sai, where is it? Here, Hui Song Sai. You see there, on the bottom, on the south. You see this is Pitbulli and Hui Song Sai on the south of the province. Okay, this is where Hui Song Sai is. And on the mid is a Gangajan, that the reservoir for Pet project, for Pitbulli project, okay? This is to show you the reservoir. No, sorry, the text is quite incorrect. The reservoir for Hui Song Sai capacity is 4 million cubic meter. It's just the learning process we discussed earlier about making a map of the themselves, reservoir, water activity, their history. Actually, it's also talk about their history. Of the village themselves, learning about themselves, okay, that's important before they come up with some solution for themselves. But have they heard to learn about each other? This is, more detail about the household and irrigation area of this Hui Song Sai that we have been showing you on the video. Okay, this is the reservoir, this is a canal system. Oh, sorry, the road, the canal set is on the blue one. Okay, they have the pipe. This is the pipe system. You see, as it go along the it fill, so it will reduce the water loss. And the left is bottom is the pipe system that used to irrigate the vegetable. This is just the water use group, four main group. Together after the installation, in 2006, this is area of 700 hectare. So this is just more detail about the main pipe, the lateral, the total length of the pipe system, that it went in 2009. In previously, they use a quite big pipe, 4 inches, and they have come out with the smaller one later, that only 3 inch, this type of thing. They have the 4 inch at the start, and that after that they have some kind of 3 inch smaller diameter of pipe. Is it just the methodology of water delivery? Maybe this one have been discussed already in the video. We skipped it, You can have a look maybe later. This calendar for the dry season and for the wet season, on the water activity, like the blue, the blue long one that is for domestic, that will be for the whole year, and for agriculture will be for 2 seasons, and for maintenance and for meeting, for some joint management committee meeting, every 2 months on the third week of the month of Lokatu. So they have calendar in place. And this is just the calendar of crops production, rice, upland crop, vegetable, fruit tea, big tree, Lokatu together. Okay. This is just the money collect from the group, you know, in each year, how much water has been collected from the group. It's quite some money, you know, for the maintenance work by themselves. So they have some saving, you know. In 2011, that they have been getting the money for far, they have the saving of $4,300. But in baht, it's 137,000 baht. That is their total saving by water collecting and take the maintenance cost out. So they have quite a number of water saving in the group. This is just group research, you know, that I talking earlier, that starting to form the water user group and working together and learning together how to improve themselves by the participatory process to research. Oh, this is somebody asking the question yesterday about check dam. In this project, you know, Hoi Song Sai, they also construct a lot of check dam upstream. You can see they use the sandbag, they use, you know, a gravel bag to go to upstream to construct this weir to stop the sediment from coming down, and also to reduce the water flow, to let water flow into the groundwater more. That is quite successful in many small scale projects and even upstream projects in Thailand. You know, this is a good example of that. You know, the water user group help the people upstream through this as a working together with people between upstream and downstream. Okay. Is it just activity? You know, like going little, I say vetiver grass to stop erosion. You know, they use the vetiver grass to stop erosion into the reservoir in the high ground area. You know, they use a vetiver grass that had very deep root depth, you know, to protect the soil erosion. So I can say that check dam, also vetiver grass can be a solution for the guy yesterday asking about stopping erosion. Okay, and here they have you know, clearing the dam site distribution system 2 times a year to remove the weed by the level of themselves. This is it's cut together. They have group activity, you know, to strengthen themselves, you know, as a community, you know, through what so every member mostly what is group coming together on the kind of certain activity. This is the kind of, I think it's a kind of meeting at the final of the research, you know, to come out with what do they learn, you know. And right now they have even the news, you know, about their own activity of the group to notify everybody in the project, you know. And they also have the field trip, you know, themselves to see some other area, you know. They go to Suphanburi, they go to some other place to learn. Okay, this is just some kind of, you know, training in the area, you know, for themselves to learn, you know, outside the area. Learning by doing, you know. This is integrated water user group meeting that we hold maybe, I think, every season that we have this a big meeting for the whole project or the whole reservoir to have a kind of design on what should be done, decide on some regulation or problem solving or some other thing, you know, that they will agree or vote on some issue, you know, every season. This is just the calendar I talked earlier, you know, and the water requirement. This is just the maintenance of big distribution system, you know, so they have to work together, replace. I think it's some kind of the pipe is broken and they have to repair by themselves. They use their own tractor or labor, just use the, you know, the funding that they collect to buy the new pipe, and then they repair it, you know, by recommendation from the IID, you know, but everything is done by themselves. This is just the overall picture of cleaning of the location nearby the pipe distribution system, you know, and nearby the reservoir. Oh, finally, I will talk very brief about service agreement. Maybe we have got much time. Your service agreement is in Thailand, it just has been placed for a long time, and not so many projects have been implemented, but it's quite interesting that we try to get the more efficiency, more reliability, and more equity by supporting a participatory, you know, the service agreement. We have, you know, mutual agreement on the paper, you know, on for the O&M water user group. You know, we have set up the standard, you know, and we have the contribution from ID, we have the contribution on water user group, and we have to set up the schedule for water distribution, you know, and our service agreement, you know, it has to come characteristic like clarity, transparency, accountability, flexible, you know, acceptability on the penalty, you know, if somebody break the rule, and also we sign the agreement. Is it just the signing ceremony, you know, on the leader of the group, you know, not individual, you know, and report this to related party like local administration. This is the ID. We will call them service provider, you know, that we have the okay, where we deliver the water, what amount, time, volume, discharge, you know, and tolerance of, you know, kind of out of target. How much water can be out of target? Let's say maybe 20% out of target is okay, but if it's more than 20, it's not okay, whatever, you know, this is called tolerance. Flexibility, the time may be a little bit flexible, you know, and the people will be informed about the delivery data, you know. And if one rotation, they don't get sufficient water, next rotation, they will get the kind of compensate water, you know, and then they are seeing a like penalty. The client is the farmer user group or the farmer, you know, so they have participated in the maintenance, they have cost sharing on the maintenance operation on some other thing, you know, and they have set up their own regulation. They must give information to Eugen project, like what is their planting area, where is it, to calculate the quantity of water, what crops, what is the planting time, you know, so we can estimate the harvest time and the water requirement, those type of thing. Is it just the process of agreement? At first, they have the irrigation system investigation, they have water delivery requirement, and we coming with this, you know, they can come out with, okay, water delivery scheduling and determination of the delivery service. And then after that, all information putting together to become service agreement preparation. And this is just standard, you know, that maybe for this agreement, you see this, they have some standard. Okay, the water quality can be, okay, out of the target, maybe 10%, 20% out of the target. It means provide 80% of the agreed rate, 80% of the efficiency, 80% of the duration, whatever, you know, it means that, okay, it can be off the target, but not, but it have to be within the limit of the agreement, you know. And equity, okay, also the last one is quite important, you know, and we have the, you know, like performance indicator for each. And we try to keep it, you know, to be sure that, okay, the service is good. When the service is good, of course, the farmer, you know, have to accept responsibility. You know, this kind of program we call it service oriented, you know, irrigation, you know. So we have the agreement on the PIM. Okay. And importantly, this agreement will work only by the water delivery that can be guaranteed in terms of time, in terms of quantity, in terms of reliability, this kind of thing. Okay. Finally, I will share with you here, you know, sorry that I rushed it up, rushed it up a little bit, you know, at the end here. You know, since today is a weekend, you know, we try to end up early so you have a time to go to how we're doing something else. It's something we learned from the Southeast Asia, you know, participation first can improve planning, and helping the people to get information, you know, and optimize the use of resources. And cost sharing, it also increase the benefit of overall, you know, between the people inside, okay? And definitely institutional reform is important. Like we discussed earlier that we have water user group, it doesn't work, we come up with a reform to help people to work better. And of course, water fee may be collect, but water fee, it should be for the group to get for the group work, not for the officer, you know, for them to work better. And then of course, we need to get the support from something like training program to the water user group. And maybe sometime we could have a look in the outside area, learning from the answer, you know. And of course, in Thailand, we have the legal framework for the establishment of water group, integrated water user group for others. So it means that it's really concrete and it can be very strong, you know, and it can be sustained in the long run. And the policy, it has to be clear that we have a policy to support the participation, and especially the participation in the irrigation project, you know, and we have the support for them to go up into the, let's say, joint management committee. It means that we support people to participate in overall management of the whole basin from the upstream to downstream, and all party that have been involved in water using, it participate. And finally here, you know, we have to be actually focused on the PIM, you know, for mean that if people if participate in the project, it could help a lot for the successful. Okay. I'm not sure how many of you today, but I think that will be end of my discussion with you. Okay. Actually, you know, next Saturday, I will be the one who have a maybe close up discussion with you. But along this time, I will distribute the new video with the English subtitle or English narrated, you know, into your video, because original video that I showed you today is all in Thai, so that's why I cut the sound out. But we are working on the completion of English. We will distribute to you sometime within this week before the end of the training on the course, you know. Okay, are there any discussion or question from participant here? Okay, if no discussion, we will end up. But anyway, we can still have discussion next Saturday on the closing, because I will be the host for the closing in order to summarize the learning, and also I can discuss with you for the whole 2 weeks what have been learned and what have been discussed, what is a merit, what is something that you feel uncomfortable with our program. So we can improve the feedback from you. We will be very much valuable for you. Okay. If it actually no discussion, we will go out early today. Okay. That will be end of my discussion today. Okay. See you again next Saturday. Bye now.
Okay, Doctor. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Any problem before next Saturday, you can put it up and discuss with me, because I have worked a lot in irrigation for a long, long time. You know, so any problem can be discussed later. Okay, thank you. See you again.